Welcome back to all of you for another interesting topic of this chapter, molecular basis of inheritance. So yesterday or in the previous video, I have told you about what the introduction of this chapter. In that I have told you what is that there was a great discussion going on between the DNA, RNA and protein as a genetic material, and for that there was a certain criteria that should be followed by each of the genetic material being a genetic material, right? So here today we are going to discuss about how the scientists get to know, okay, DNA is a genetic material, and there was a certain experiment by that they confirmed that gradually, okay, this is the genetic material or DNA is the best genetic material, right? So what is that topic is what? Search for the genetic material. So search for the genetic material, as you know very well, Mendel has proposed the law of inheritance around 1869, and there was another person, name of that person was a Mischer, right? He has proposed he discovered the structure that we call as a nucleon, or you can say nowadays nucleus. And Mendel, what Mendel did, Mendel proposed a law of inheritance, laws of inheritance. So both of them were saying the same thing, okay, in the nucleus there is a structure that is responsible for the inheritance. Mendel was saying there was a factor that was the responsible for the inheritance, but nobody was able to tell us, okay, basically which substance is responsible for the inheritance, right? So this discovery was around 1869 or 1866. But gradually with the time passed, there was a research going on, and the research reaches up to the molecular level of inheritance. And by that, there was a person, name of that person was F. Griffith. So F. Griffith was a person who has first time did an experiment to get to know, okay, what is the basically material that passed from the one generation to the next generation, or you can say one cell to the another cell. So that experiment is actually known as a transforming principle. Transforming principle. So what is the transforming principle? In this, what Griffith did, he just took one of the bacteria, name of that bacteria is Streptococcus pneumoniae. What was the name of bacteria? Name of that bacteria was a Streptococcus pneumoniae. It means this is the bacteria that is responsible for the disease pneumonia. Pneumonia. Right? It means it's a pathogenic bacteria. So what he did, he just did a number of experiment with this bacteria, and he grow number of strain of this bacteria in an artificial culture medium. So what he did, now today we will discuss what he did actually. He just took a this Streptococcus bacteria and culture on a medium, right? What he did in transforming principle, what he did, he just cultured this bacteria where in a different culture medium, and he got two type of colony, transforming Streptococcus pneumoniae. Right, where in a culture medium, and he got two type of strain of this bacteria. One was having a colony of a smooth and shiny. One colony of the bacteria was a smooth and shiny, and one colony of this bacteria was a rough. Right? Why it was there? Because due to this colony is having a capsule over the cell wall, and due to presence of a substance of polysaccharide mucus. So that is a polysaccharide that was present in some of the bacteria. But in some of the bacteria, it was not there. So those who were not having this, they were the rough in nature, and those who were having this, they were in the smooth and shiny. And along with that, what he knows it very well, these were the virulent strain of the bacteria, and these were the non-viral. It means they are non-pathogenic, and rough colony was a non-pathogenic, and the smooth colony of the bacteria was the pathogenic in nature. And how they are pathogenic? Because they are responsible for a disease that we call as a pneumonia, right? So after growing this strain of bacteria, what he did, he just introduced or he just inject this strain, both the strain of bacteria were in the mouse. Okay, so what he did, he just took as a strain and injected into the mice. So what he got to know, mice died. That mice was died, right? After that, what he did, he again take a rough strain, we call rough strain as a smooth and shiny strain, we call it as a S strain, and the rough strain we call it as a R strain, right? After that, what he did, R strain again injected into the mice. What he see, mice was live, right? Now he got to know, okay, this is the strain. By this experiment, actually, what he got to know this strain is infected or virulent, or you can say pathogenic in nature, and this strain is non-pathogenic in nature. After that, during that time, actually, Griffith was aware about how to kill the bacteria by heating. So what he did, he just heat killed as a strain bacteria, right? And after that, again, what he did, that heat killed as a strain bacteria, he injected into the mouse. What he saw this time, he saw that mouse was alive. He was not dead, right? And again, what he did, he now introduced this heat killed S strain bacteria with the R strain bacteria. So heat killed S strain plus R strain, right? Both the strain were mixed together, injected into the mouse. What he seen, again he saw that mouse dead. Hard as possible. Now you know very well, heat strain is mean something is killed, because when he saw this experiment, when he did this experiment, mice was alive. But again, when he mixed this heat killed S strain bacteria with the R strain, what he got to know, mouse was dead. All the mice would die. How it is possible? It means that R strain, those who were that were non-virulent in nature, now it's become virulent. It means something has passed from this S strain into the R strain, and by that R strain change its nature, you can say its pathogenic, non-pathogenic nature can change into the pathogenic nature. So by this experiment, what Griffith told us there is a something that transform this R strain into the S strain, and due to that they are behaving as a pathogenic in nature, and that principle we call it as a transforming principle, and it was given by the F. Griffith. So this experiment is actually going on around 1929, and after that he was not sure, okay, which is, because when we talk about the something has passed, maybe this is a DNA, maybe this is a RNA, maybe this is a protein, because these structures are present where inside the nucleus, right? So this was the experiment given by the F. Griffith. After that, there was a three person again. Name of that person was the Avery, McLeod and McCarty. They were the three scientists. What he did? He just go through with the transforming principle of the F. Griffith, and he confirmed that actually what is passing from one that S strain into the R strain, and that we call as a biochemical characterization of transforming principle. So this was given by three person, Avery, McLeod these are the surname and McCarty. So these were the person who has did this experiment, and by that they proved that actually from the S strain there was a DNA who is responsible for transforming of the R strain into the S strain. So what he did, he just proved that DNA is a genetic material. So what they did actually, in the coming chapter you will get to know for the digestion of the each part of the cell. For example, if we talk about the plasma membrane, so plasma membrane is made up of a lipid, means for the digestion of the lipid there is an enzyme that required lipase. Same with the, if the there is a cell wall made up of chitin, the enzyme is required chitinase. If the there is a RNA, for the digestion of RNA there is a requirement of a RNase enzyme. For the protein there is a digestion of a for the protein digestion there is a need of a protease enzyme. Same with the DNA also, there is a need of a DNase enzyme. So what actually they did, they just extract the S strain from that culture colony, and they just go with the all the enzymes with that bacterial cell, and one by one they digest each part of the bacterial cell with the different enzyme. For example, this is a bacterial cell, and bacterial cell is having a cell wall, right? Cell wall, again after that it is having a RNA, it is having a protein, and it is having a DNA also, right? And the cell wall, you know very well, it is made up of a polysaccharide or the mucopolysaccharide, polypeptidoglycan is the name of the. So for the digestion there is a need of a different enzyme, right? For RNAs there is a need of RNase enzyme, for protein there is a need of a protease enzyme, right? For cell wall digestion there is a need of a cellulose enzyme. Again, if the cell wall is made up of polysaccharide, the name of the enzyme that is required for the digestion is the polysaccharidase enzyme. So all the enzymes are required. So what he did, he just took one by one. When he just killed this RNA with the RNase enzyme, that time there was a no change in that transformation of R strain into the S strain. When there was a protein were digested with the enzyme, there was a no change between the there is no transformation of the R strain into the S strain, right? So it was very simple. But what he did, when he digests this DNA with the DNA enzyme, it means DNA is killed, right? So in that case, what was there, if it is there is a S strain, he killed S strain, and now after digestion with the DNA's enzyme, it is mixed with the R strain and injected into the mouse, right? In that condition mice was alive. How it was alive? Because now that DNA is killed, it means DNA was the factor, DNA was the biochemical or substance that was required for the transformation of the transformation of the R strain into the S strain. So by this experiment, MacLeod, Avery and McCarty proved that what that is, a DNA is a genetic material, right? And this we call as a biochemical characterization of transforming principle. Children, this is very important. Number of times it is asked in your board exam. Who was that? Actually they used to ask what is the transforming principle and what is the biochemical character, who has proposed the biochemical characterization of the transforming principle, and we used to write just a F. Griffith experiment. So you should be very careful when it is asked. Transforming principle is entirely different. That was the initial or the first step for this proved experiment. But if we talk about the biochemical characterization, so it was given by three persons, that was Avery, MacLeod and McCarty, and they just by the digestion of different enzyme to the bacterial cell, they just proved that okay, DNA is the basic genetic material. So this is all about your biochemical characterization of transforming principle, and by that we are saying nowadays that DNA is a genetic material. So in coming video, next coming video, I will tell you about what? I will tell you about the there is another person who has proposed this or characterized or prove us that okay, DNA is a genetic material, that we will discuss in a coming video. Thank you.